Epilepsy. When you look in the mirror, are you happy with who you see? This is Stacey Chillemi, and in this episode, we're going to talk about learning to love yourself again. Epilepsy is like a roller coaster ride. It has many highs and lows. There were times when my epilepsy was doing well that I didn't even feel like a person with epilepsy anymore. I even forgot that I had epilepsy, believe it or not. Every day I lived life according to the limitations I set for myself and followed the diet and lifestyle I created, which I knew helped my seizures stay under control. I actually felt normal. Then, eventually, a seizure would creep up on me, and I was reminded that I wasn't normal. I was a woman who lived life with a serious condition. A woman who had to remember to take her medicine every day. A person who had to live with limitations. And I had to create a lifestyle that wouldn't cause me to overstress so I wouldn't have seizures. Did I mention that I hate limitations? That I'm the type of person who likes to do things her way? A person who is independent and doesn't like anyone to tell her what to do? Do you know how frustrating it is when you are capable of accomplishing so much more, but you can't, because if you overdo it, you will cause yourself to have a seizure? My question to you is, when you look in the mirror, are you happy with who you see? When my epilepsy condition is doing fantastic and my seizures are under control, it is then when I can look in the mirror and truly say, I like what I see. I am even able to take all the hardships that I experienced from my epilepsy and put it behind me. But when my epilepsy doesn't do well, looking in the mirror isn't so easy to do. You can be the hottest looking man or woman on the planet, but if you're not happy with the person you've become, then looking in the mirror isn't such an easy task to accomplish. How do you feel when you're looking in the mirror at yourself? When my epilepsy isn't doing well, I'd look in the mirror and tears would roll down my eyes. I would feel frustrated with life, angry on the inside, asking God, why me, God? I would become depressed, and as the seizures would keep coming, I would feel more and more depressed. I felt like I fell in a deep hole, and as each day passed, I felt like the hole became deeper. So what do? Do you give up and stop looking in the mirror? Or do you become determined to find the person you once loved when you would look in the mirror? For me, I refused to give up. I wasn't happy, but I wasn't going to spend the rest of my life feeling like this. And I didn't want to give up on life, even though there were times when life didn't seem like it was worth living with epilepsy. So this is what I did to save myself. I wanted a happy life. I deserved it. And so do you. Why should I let a condition like epilepsy get the best of me? It's not fatal. There are many people on this planet who have it a lot worse than me. So this is what I did. Learn to love yourself again. Self-love may be the greatest and most important love you'll ever experience in your life. Learning to love yourself may seem like a difficult task to achieve. Many people try to show a facade. They go around acting happy like nothing is wrong and life couldn't be better. But on the inside, they hurt emotionally. They have emotional chains wrapped around their hearts. Love cannot enter their hearts. Their hearts are locked, so they cannot let the gift of love flow from their hearts into someone else's heart. They walk around with pain and emotional suffering because they are angry, perhaps because they have epilepsy. They may feel different because others can drive and they cannot. For whatever reason, they are drowning in hidden pain that no one knows about except for them. Now you can stop all this. It's time to find the key and unlock the chains wrapped around your heart. It's time to learn to love yourself once again. An important way to love yourself is to take care of yourself emotionally, physically, and spiritually. You need to take time out for yourself. Do things that strike your interest, that you enjoy doing. You need to go out and have fun. Go to a diner, go dancing, go see a movie, go to a baseball game, take a walk on the beach. Don't sit home and analyze yourself. Don't criticize yourself. You may get angry and criticize yourself and your life. You need to stop those negative thoughts and actions and replace them with positive thoughts. No one is perfect. We all have something. When you begin to think negative, immediately stop yourself and change your thought into a positive one. If you tell yourself that you are a failure, you are much more likely to fail than if you picture yourself a success. There is nothing wrong to give yourself a pat on the back. You need to give yourself a little boost to be a winner. Reward yourself when you do something to better yourself. Give yourself something special. Take time out each day to tell yourself, I accept that I have epilepsy. I am no different than anyone else. I am beautiful and bright, or I love myself. I am loving, caring, and worthy of love in life, or I believe in myself. Write those things down and put them where you can see them every day. You must realize that what is most important is not what others think about you, it's how you feel about yourself. In order to feel good about yourself, you need to accept yourself. You must look at yourself positively and realize that there is no such thing as a perfect person. What's most important in our life is that we try to master our daily troubles that come our way and overcome the problems that have already occurred in our lives. Now, this is something that should be considered a triumph. If you are unhappy with yourself, then you need to do something about it. Ignoring your problems and your emotions and not dealing with them is the easy way out. To face them and to deal with them are accomplishments. Accepting ourselves helps us to grow mentally, physically, and spiritually. Remember, it's not how we look on the outside that's important. It's how we feel on the inside that matters the most. In this life, in order to survive, it is important that we accept ourselves for who we are. We need to feel good about ourselves and carry an inner strength so we can live a happy, healthy, and productive life. When we are young, we have people in our lives who help mold us. They help us develop strength, wisdom, and knowledge. These are the characteristics that we need to survive in this world. Yet many of us forget what we learned and we focus on what is unimportant, such as how we look on the outside. In the end, you're going to feel emotionally drained and unable to live a productive life. Everyone on this earth is here for a reason. We need to pass on what we have learned along to others. It is selfish and pure laziness to pity ourselves. You must learn to accept and love yourself. You are not alone. Many people feel unhappy with themselves. To live with and accept yourself, you need to open your heart and listen to what your heart is telling you. Your heart will never lie to you. Your heart always tells the truth. You must have the courage to ask your heart why you refuse to love yourself. You need to help yourself by accepting yourself and loving yourself for who you are. This is the first step in order to heal yourself and feel good about who you are as a person. Here are 7 steps to help you learn to love and accept yourself. Step 1. Accept your epilepsy. It's not going away, so accept it and move forward in life. Step 2. Look at life from a positive perspective. Don't be one of those people who say, well, there's nothing good in my life, because I guarantee you there is a lot of good things in your life. Step 3. Focus on your strengths. Look at the positive strengths in your life. Step 4. Changing your outlook on epilepsy. This means not letting your epilepsy take control of you. As I was growing up, I always made believe that I did not have epilepsy. By doing this, I was only hurting myself. Accepting epilepsy into my life has helped me tremendously. I have released much of the anger that I held inside myself, and I focus on other parts of my life. As a result, I've become stronger as a person and extremely proud of the person that I have become in life. You need to do the same thing. It may take time to get to this point, but it's worth it. Step 5, have patience. Rome wasn't built in a day. All accomplishments and achievements take time. Step 6, believe in yourself. You need to believe in yourself and believe that you can do anything you put your mind to. If you believe in yourself, then others will believe in you too. Step 7, have a tremendous amount of pride in yourself. The bottom line is, in order to change and strengthen yourself, you must accept yourself and learn to live with yourself. You need to look at life in a positive way, and you need to say to yourself, okay, I'm not happy with the person that I see in front of that mirror. I need to change, and this is what I'm going to do about it. Don't say I can't. You can. Be proud of who you are. Be thankful each morning that you wake up and you feel the warmth of the sun and the beauty that surrounds us all. Love yourself, be good to yourself, and treat yourself well. The more you love yourself, the more you'll be able to love others. And others will feel this positive energy, and they'll want to be around you too. By loving yourself, you will help the lives of others around you, as well as your own life. I hope this segment, when you look in the mirror, are you happy with who you see? Learning to love yourself again has helped you. Please leave a comment in the comment box. I'd love to hear your thoughts, and I'd love to hear how you feel. Are you happy with the person you see when you look in the mirror? Let me know what your thoughts are. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you can hear more videos about epilepsy and about helping yourself.